Then, I believe that's our ring.
I believe it was, too. That was three longs, I believe.
Well, that's our ring.
Oh, good.
I'll get it.
All right.
Hello, jot 'em down, store. This is Lyman Abner.
Now, let's see what's going on down at Pine Ridge.
Well, don't Squire know Lum's found him out yet, Abner?
Found him where?
Found out old Squire's a whole Red X gang personal, all by himself. Nobody with him.
Oh, no, not yet, Grandpap. Squire more likely be in here before long, old, trying to get Lum to sign that insurance policy, and then old Lum will jump all over
it. I hope so.
Oh, I just can't wait to see old Squire's face.
Oh, he'll squirm like a fishing worm, squawk like a jaybird. Deny the whole thing, of course.
But we got him dead to rights, Grandpap. You seen him chalk a Red X on the dress goods counter, and he seen him chalk up a Red X on the porch out there.
Sure I did.
Then there was some red chalk on that insurance policy left here come off his hand.
Oh, he's a Red X gang, all
sure
right.
Sure.
No doubts about it.
No.
He figured out the whole idea just so Lum could get scared into taking out that life insurance.
Sure. Of course, Squire wouldn't have actually done Lum any harm.
Well, he might not have scared Lum to death, though.
I know it. Got Lum to where he feared to show himself. Kept himself hid down there in that little old place dug out under the store. Thought every breath he drawed might be the last one.
Oh, that Squire's a varmint. I just can't hardly stand the sight of him no more. P-U-G.
You know something? It serves Squire right if Lum would take that policy and then drop dead just to get even with her. No, that wouldn't do no good, would it?
That's some life insurance policy, all right. Covers everything from dying of the Black Plague to getting ran over by a flying saucer.
Yeah? Well, Lum's always been a healthy fella, you know, and Squire knows he ain't taking no risk.
It's Squire's own company. Just got it up, didn't he?
Yeah, sure. It'd break Squire if he had to pay out $10,000, take every dime and piece of property he's got.
Did you say Lum's down there in that hole in the ground now? He don't have to hide out no more now that he knows there ain't nobody trying to kill him.
Well, he's still going to keep that trunk full of jewelry and stuff down there, though, Grandpap. See, he don't want nobody else to know what's in it till he finds out what he ought to do with it.
Yeah, I wish he'd bring some of that stuff up here. I'd just love to see some of it.
Well, that's what he's doing, sort of sorting it out. A whole bunch of different things in there. Pearl necklaces, diamond bracelets, rings, fancy pins, medallions.
Medallions? What's a medallion?
I don't know. I always thought it was some kind of a green till Lum explained it to me. Little card fastened to some of the things, telling what they're. Medallions was one of them he named, I know. And some women's compacts and cigarette cases and, just one thing or another.
If it don't sound like Lum stumbled on to something, all right.
Oh, yeah.
He might have a gold mine down there in that hole in the ground.
No, it ain't a gold mine, Grandpap. See, me and Lum dug that hole down there when we had the bank going. That hole was to keep the safe in. We weren't digging for no gold mine.
I know it, I know
Whatever gave you the idea is a gold mine down there. It's a trunk.
Forget it. I'm sorry I brung it up.
It's a trunk full of...
I'm sorry I brung it up.
When'd you do that? Did you and Lum bring it up last night?
Bring what up?
The trunk.
I never brought up no trunk.
Grandpap, you sat right there and said you were sorry you brought it up. I said there was a trunk down there and you said you were sorry you brought it up. Here, I thought the trunk was still down in there all the time.
It is. The trunk's still down there.
Oh, you're taking it back down again, huh?
Yeah, that's right. Wait a second. I believe Lum's coming up out of the hole now.
Awful.
Maybe he's bringing some of them jewelries up for us to look at.
Yeah.
Howdy, Lum. What have you got there?
Doggies, that's a pretty thing you got around your neck there, Lum.
Yeah, Grandpap. How do I look?
What in the world is that thing, Lum?
Oh, it's one of them medallions, I reckon. It's got a card attached to it, but I ain't read it yet because the printing's kind of small and that cool oil lamp was starting to smart my eyes. Ain't it a beauty, though?
Well, it's sure big enough.
I do know. It's shaped like one of them old Egyptian sarcophagus glasses or whatever you call them.
Sarcophagus glasses?
I've saw pictures of them in magazines. Kind of a coffin they used to bury them Egyptians in.
Well, I never heard of one of them things.
I believe that's for your time, Abner. And look at that gold cockroach right in the center there. Or a beetle, I reckon it is.
Well, I don't...
Yeah, there's some hieroglyphics on the bottom of the thing.
Hieroglyphics?
Don't you know what a hieroglyphic is, Abner?
I don't even know what a loroglyphic is. What's that thing carved around the top there, Lum? That looks like a snake.
I think that's one of them asps. I believe they was the old Egyptians' favorite kind of a snake. Used to carry them around with them all the time. Come in handy to suicide themselves with.
No.
You know something? If this thing is genuine, I might have an awful old and valuable treasure right there in this one medallion here.
Try it on, Abner. Let's see how you look at it.
Get that thing away from me, Lum. Coughing, snakes, cockroaches, hieroglyphics. I don't want nothing to do with it.
Well, it ain't going to hurt you.
Take it away.
Here, let's take a look and see what it says on the card. Get the thing off so I can read
it. Get your mind out, Lum. Here comes old Squire Skin.
More likely coming over to get you to sign that insurance policy.
Don't let Squire see that sarcophagus gal, Lum. He'd pester you to death till he gets the half owners in that trunk.
Well, Squire ain't going to get nothing out of me.
Well, put that Egyptian in your pocket before he sees it.
Yeah, there. Just can't wait to give Squire a piece of my mind, trying to hook me into buying that insurance, trying to scare me into it, that dead...
Well, gentlemen.
Come in, Squire.
Howdy, Squire.
Making a...
Well, I'm old chum, as you can probably guess, I've come over to see why you haven't signed and returned that excellent insurance policy I left here for you yesterday. In fact, I'm a little amazed that a fellow with as little time to live as you've got, you have signed the thing, no doubt.
Squire, I had a nice little speech made up for whenever you showed up here again, but I'm so dead blamed riled up over your ornery tic-tacs, I've got a notion to let you have it all in one lump, right on top of the head.
Now, hold on, Lum. What in the world's got into you? I've gone out of my way to draw you up the finest insurance policy $240 can buy. And with that Red X gang after you like the aura,
Lum. If I do whop you on the head, I'll be whopping the whole dad blamed Red X gang along with it. Because you conniving old skin flint, you snake in the weeds, you are the Red X.
Not just a minute. I can explain everything.
Get out of here. Take your insurance policy and get out of here before I puff up and bust all over
you. Now, just let me explain something here.
Get out.
I guess I can take a hint. I'm going. I'm on my way. In fact, I'm out.
I believe he caught on all right.
I just loved and admired the way Lum told old Squire what was what there. Do it again, Lum. I'd like to hear that all over again.
No, fellas, once is enough. I don't want to get too steamed up. I'm liable to blow my lid. Besides, I'm anxious to see what the card says on this medallion here.
Oh, yes.
Get out of my light there, Abner. It's a pretty small print. Move over a little.
I'll be glad to. I don't like the looks of that thing. I just don't like the looks of it.
Says here, facsimile. Grannies.
Is that what it is, a facsimile?
That ain't the name of it. That means it's the real thing.
Real thing?
Yeah, it's took from the word fax, I believe, and similar. It means the same. Fact is, it is the same. I might have a fortune in this thing here.
Well, what else does it say on there, Lum?
Read some more there. This is interesting. Facsimile of medallion taken from the tomb of King Tutankhamun, 10th dynasty of Egypt, 1358 B.C. Say, I recollect back in 1922 when some fellers uncovered that King Tut's tomb. Ever dad blame one of them fellers died a mysterious death, too.
I know it. Don't get that thing near me, Lum.
Wait a second. Let me read the rest of this thing here. Looks like a little poem.
Huh?
Yeah. It says, beware, O thou, on whose breast this golden curse has come to rest.
Oh, my sake,
Lum. Catch up, Abner. Don't go getting scared. Cleanse your heart and mend your ways. Your years have fled. You have but days. Grannies, I had this thing on my chest, Abner.
Yeah.
I've only got a few days left. Call Squire, Abner. Tell him I forgive him. Tell him I've changed my mind about that insurance policy. Grannies, I'll take it.